I've lived most of my supposed adult life desperately avoiding cliches. This has led to me falling back asswards into many cliches, which is in and of itself a cliche, and the appropriate amount of shame befalls me, not just for knowing, but for discussing it. It's the kind of sad shame that keeps you awake for nights googling one-way ticket discount flights, telling yourself people are super forgetful, or don't worry, tomorrow someone will fuck up worse. But there is one cliche that's never bothered me. My childhood blanket. I named it Blankie. Because that's what kids do. Toss a Y sound to the end of things. It's cute and symptomatic of the fact that in our early lives we are talked to in chirpy, reassuring tones. So Blankie is called Blankie. It's uncreative, overly simplistic. It's the farthest thing from original one can get, and to this day. It sits wrapped in my closet in case I need it. And if you don't like it, go fuck yourself. The world can be a shitty, scary place, and we shouldn't be embarrassed from where we draw our strengths. Because it's not about loneliness. It's not about personifying something into companionship. I'm not a child in the corner proudly declaring I know who my real friends are. Blankie held me as a child, as an adult I hold it, to hold on to a piece of the past, a piece of potential too valuable to leave behind and too precious to leave out in the open, something that doesn't change even though I change. I've noticed with increasing regularity that there has to be an importance to the importance we put on things. We can give weight to an object just like we can give weight to people, as if we cried out catch and hurled a chunk of pure gold in their face. Sure, it's free gold, but at free-flying speeds it's also a considerably dense element. The extended family of brothers and sisters who didn't know I'd come along and imply importance to my knowing them. The poor girls I misplaced my desperation on to fix a problem that only I could control, the ones that could never love me back. I think about them the most. Like pushing on a bruise that hurts just enough to know I'm alive, but the ones I couldn't bring myself to love flutter my mind, barbed wire butterflies hitting soft memory tissue. The more they struggle to get free, the tighter they wrap themselves to that part of my memory is numb enough to let them slip free. Cause sometimes my affections can be too much, misplaced or not enough, and sometimes I'm ashamed of the things I've done, or said I said, or said I done, cause I get so many of the little things wrong, and yeah, I'm gonna make mistakes, and yeah, maybe this is one of them, but they're my mistakes, I made them. Cause we'd all be perfect if we could live life just one day in advance so we could fact check and edit out plot holes. There still isn't an app for keeping track of all my loose ends till then, so confusion and self-delusion aren't excuses, they're facts of life. If you think I'm wrong, don't worry. You're just being delusional. People who know who they are still a moment away from having to rethink everything. So not knowing what the next second might bring, what shoe is going to drop next, the things we can't see coming, the things we don't know we forgot, it all comes around. Unless it doesn't. So it's nice to go back to a time when I was pure potential. No mistakes were mine yet, and everything was original because I'd never done it before. So Blankie is called Blankie. It's cliche and unoriginal, maybe it's my first mistake, but I've named a ton of stuff since then, and while I do think I'm getting better at it, Blankie still holds the weight I put on him, and he helps me with the weights you asked me to carry. So I'll never be ashamed of my Blankie. And don't you fucking dare laugh at someone else's, because you have no idea what weight you put on them.